Good morning. As we approach day four, we have done quite a bit of cleaning. We have also done an audit of our lives. So our house is quite sorted, clean, and we have a lot of more clarity. But what if in this perfect house there is a stench, some foul odor? No matter how much air fragrance you spray, it doesn't seem to go away. You know what I'm talking about. This stench or this foul odor is though that of our negative thoughts. Yes, we all know how damaging this kind of thinking is for us, for our mental health, for the environment around us, and it destroys the whole harmony of the house. But somehow we are not able to get out of this loop. Yes, it is a loop. It keeps playing in circles. So how do we address that? Today we are going to talk about it. See, the primary reason why we get develop these negative thoughts is because of our feeling of powerlessness, a feeling of being victimized. When we do not get our primary basic needs are not met, we feel powerless, and then we start complaining. And these basic needs are lack of love. When we don't feel we are loved, when we don't feel we are cared for, when we don't feel we are understood, and we don't feel respected, or when we don't get what we deserve, this triggers a feeling of negative thoughts in our mind. It could be a very simple incident when if our child back answers, immediately we develop that loop that no, he does not respect us. You know, what are kids doing these days? And then what we do? We go and complain to somebody. We crib about it. We feel it is our venting out. We just want to relieve ourselves of that burden which we are carrying by putting the blame on somebody, you know, outside, externally. It comforts us to do that. And we feel unburdened. But that is a temporary feeling. Just like allopathic medicine, you feel a temporary relief, but the problem does not go away. So then, how do we handle this? What do we have to do? We all know that in our minds, rationally, we know when the other person has said something to us, it doesn't mean too much. We know he must be in his own thing, and due to which he lashes out, but we get that particular feeling. So for that, the best way is to cut. Firstly, understand this has happened. So the first C, which is cut. Cut away from whatever he's telling to you, you know, so that, you know, you are detached. So he's free to move on his own journey and you go your own ways. And then whatever feeling it has left in your mind, cleanse. Cleanse meaning you just let go of it. And that comes with forgiveness. When you forgive the other person immediately for whatever he has done, in your mind you can say that loud, that okay, I forgive you, I felt hurt and I forgive you. Mentally you can say that and leave, let the other person go. You will be much calmer. And then change. Do not keep standing there. Just move to a different position. Maybe you could physically move away from the place, or change that in your mind, that okay, he has had a bad day, that is why he shouted at me. So you are cutting, cleaning, and changing. So these are the three C's which we follow, with which you can bring about this change, and from the position where it just began. So the damage is not done so much. When it lingers with you, or if it remains, then what do we do? In our behavior, in our actions, how do we address that? That we can do by firstly stop complaining about it. No matter how tempted you are to complain, crib or vent out, just stop yourself at that moment. Do not complain. Initially you might feel a little, you know, that I want to do it, but trust me, when you restrain yourself at that moment, gradually you will get accustomed to dealing it in a healthier way. Stay away from people who are in the habit of negative talk. People who are constant complainers, because their negativity passes on to you. So steer away. Even if you have to be in the company, you create an invisible wall. Do not pay much heed to them. and also try to steer the conversation to a more neutral topic. So these are the few things that we can do. And also reminding you, like we talked yesterday, negative people have a lot of effect in draining or sapping our mental energy. So we have to protect our energy by creating that barrier. So that exercise that follows today is on the same lines. How can you cut, cleanse, and change the loop of negative thoughts wherever you catch yourselves or find yourselves getting into this loop? Do these three things and share your experience, how it turned out to you. Second exercise, staying away from negative talk, consumption of negative media, negative news, so many cases rising, you know, all the negativity around wherever you can. Just stay away from all negativity. Let them do their bit, you stay away. Let that trash not rub onto you. So try doing this and let me know what you feel. Good day.